I took about a 3,000 mile trip to Sturgis and back this summer. And on my trip up to Sturgis, I realized that at about 75, 80 miles an hour, you can't hear the radio that comes from this factory stock head unit from Harley-Davidson. So on that trip, I basically rode up there and back with the radio on, but couldn't hear it. And I felt like, man, as soon as I get home, I've got to do something to change that and to where I can actually hear my stereo.
We're on location at Spokes Garage. We're working on this beautiful 24 Road Glide. Trying a few things on it because the Kenwood system we're installing works on your 14 to 23 Harley completely plug and play. The 24s are a little different. So we're gonna try a few things. Nice thing about this kit, everything's labeled, your input, your power wire. You can actually replace your really, really sad Harley speaker for a much better Kenwood unit made of carbon fiber, a lot more power handling. 160 watt two channel amplifier, comes with brackets for your Harley-Davidson, and we'll see how this goes.
So I've done business with Creative Audio here at the shop for a few years now, and I was actually having some work done on one of my classic cars, and while we were there, we started discussing the Harley issues with the speaker volume and came up with a solution, and that's why we went with that.
You're gonna see a massive improvement. I mean, just the speakers alone will be a massive improvement on this thing.
If I can hear it going down the road, I'm gonna be really happy. But as I'm telling you, at 80 miles an hour, with just the wind noise and all that, which I have a different windshield that I usually ride on the highway, if I don't know the song, I won't know what song it is.
So we've got the fairing off the bike. As you can see, here's our Rockford factory amplifier. Now this must remain inside the bike. These are your speaker connectors. They literally are just right here. Simply, you can plug them in, plug them out. Kenwood literally gives you the same plugs. So, they only plug in one way. Yeah, can't screw it up. There's your inputs. These will plug into your amplifier for your signal in, and then your signal out simply plugs right back in. So now you have signal into the amp, signal out to the amp. You'll run a power and a ground through the fairing under the gas tank to the battery under the seat. And with a little bit of signal turn on, your amplifier install will be done.
I've been an avid motorcycle rider my entire life since I was 17, 18 years old, and kind of just turned my hobby into my career. I had another career and I retired from that and began doing this full time. The bike is a 2024 Road Glide. It's their standard model. We did add a fat tire kit, wheels, custom paint, now custom audio. So we pretty much always buy a bike every year and buy and build and sell kind of a bike. To be honest, I've enjoyed this bike so much I may hang on to it for a little bit, but they're really a great motorcycle and these 2024s are a lot of fun.
We're gonna go ahead and drop the speakers in real quick. These grills just pop off. There's four screws that hold the speaker in. You pop the speaker out. Your factory connectors are sized, kind of a medium and a large. And the Kenwoods have the same situation. A medium and a large uses the factory type connector, so they'll plug in nice and firm. You won't have any problems with your speaker leads coming out. And these speakers drop right in and bolt into the factory location using the factory hardware. Really, really simple upgrade. So you can lose this really weak looking factory speaker. So we pulled the tank off, pulled the seat off to have access to the battery, to run our power wire. Whenever Harley builds these bikes, they install this nice piece to protect all the wiring from the motor and the heat and everything. It's pretty simple to get to. Couple bolts here, couple bolts there. There's a quick disconnect on your fuel line now. Two hoses here to disconnect and one electrical connection. The whole tank lifts up and off. You pop the cover off this and you can safely run all your wiring with the factory wiring. There's a distribution block type piece for different connectors. Then you've got a computer that sits on top of the battery, which you need two hands to get out. And then your battery's underneath. So you'll run this down. Everything is pre-terminated, already has a fuse in it. Hook up your power and ground and then reassemble the bike. And you can finish your connections inside the fairing. So we've got our power wire ran. We've got our T harnesses plugged in for the speaker wire for our signal. Now with the 24s, they're a little different than 23s. We have to have a remote turn on lead. So when you order this for your 24, be very specific. We'll send you the amp with the turn on lead on it. We've actually probed the bike out and there's an ignition, accessory ignition turn on right here. This small blue with the yellow stripe and this harness, this wire actually runs the halo. It's a 12 volt source and you just need milliamps to turn on your amplifier. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna make a military style connection. I've got some nice strippers. You can use some different ones if you want. Take a pick tool or flat blade screwdriver. Open the wire up, wrap it around itself. And now you have a nice strong connection that will not come loose or vibrate on your Harley. So we're gonna make sure this connection's well insulated. Put it back in the loom and tape it up. The nice feature about this Kenwood amplifier, it's already pre-flashed. You don't have to take your Harley to Harley-Davidson and get it flashed to have the stereo flatlined. These all come with a firmware with crossover and EQ points. This amplifier takes care of that for you. So it is a plug and play unit minus one wire to be attached to the bike and that's it. Speakers installed. We've got the amplifier wired up with all the factory plugs. This Kenwood amp drops down in between the Rockford amp and the actual screen itself and just sits here. The nice thing is the fan will go right back on, keeps the amplifier nice and tight, nice and waterproof. So everything can go right back to factory pretty quickly if you ever choose to.
Creative Audio is fantastic to work with. And again, I can't say enough about how clean everything they do is. Everything looks like it came from the factory and nothing's cobbled together. It really looks nice. Their installs are top notch. Since we did the upgrade, it's been fantastic. The Kenwood system that we installed works perfectly. The volume level is much better. The clarity is much better. You can hear it at speed. It's much more enjoyable to ride now with the radio than it ever was before. It's really made riding way more enjoyable for me.
Like the t-shirt says, cheap ain't cool, and cool ain't cheap.